Hi everyone, this is Cyril Savio. Today I came with a video on NUID registration. My first video was on how to track your NUID status. Thanks for those who supported me. In that video, many of nurses, especially those who works abroad, asked me regarding the procedure of NUID registration through NRTS web portal. But I understand that still many nurses are not yet finished with their NUID registration. So I thought it will be helpful if I do a video on the same. Now I am here to explain the steps for NUID registration in detail. First of all, you have to Google it NRTS. Here is the search result. You have to click the first result. The main web page will open like this. You have to click for new user. After the selection of new user tab, it will take you to another page. Here some selection boxes will appear. You have to select enrolment registration for this enrolment process. You have to select the box enrolment registration. After the selection, it will ask to fill you the form by providing relevant details. In role type, you have to select nurse. In the registered as box, you have to select according to your registration certificate. Please see your registration certificate. Here you have to enter the present registration number in your registration certificate. After entering your registration number, you have to select the state. Please keep in mind that you have to select at present where you have registered. If you did your BSc nursing from Karnataka and now you transferred your registration, or you took NOC from Karnataka Nursing Council and you registered Kerala, then you have to enter state Kerala. 10 years before, there was an option without taking NOC or transfer, you can register in the other states also. If you did the same, then you have to select the primary state nursing council state name here. After that, you have to enter your full name that is mentioned in your registration certificate, then your email address, then your mobile number, and finally CAPTCHA. Then you have to click it for submit, the final submit. Then you will get a pop-up message, registration is successful. After successfully registering, click on back to login. Here you have to enter the username and password along with the CAPTCHA to authenticate and assess the application. Then it will ask you to verify the mobile number or email address here. To verify the mobile number, you have to click not verified. Then it will ask you to generate the OTP. In most of the cases, while verifying your mobile number, it will show error message. So you have to back to the verifying page. First of all, you have to verify then your email address. To verify your email address, click there. Here you have to generate OTP for your email address. Please check your email inbox. Then click to submit, then it will automatically verify your email address. You have to verify your mobile number. So what you have to do, you have to enter the OTP that you are received in email address. After entering the OTP, please click to submit. So it will show the both mobile number and email is verified. To enter the further details, you have to log out from here, then log in once again. So we are now at NRTS profile page. Here we have to select the tab Enter Nurse Details. When nurse select the Enter Nurse Details, he is able to visualize a form asking several details in tabs. So you have to carefully enter the details like applicant name, date of birth, your Aadhaar card number, registered as, and your registration number. The details you have to carefully enter. To know your date of registration, please check your registration certificate. After filling the all tabs, you have to submit the page. In this page, you have to enter your personal details like father's name, mother's name, and other personal details. If you want to change your name in registration certificate, there is an option, but you have to submit a valid proof, that is a gazetted notification. Here in this tab, you have to enter your address, permanent address and current address. After entering the wall details, like your personal details, you can click to update it. In this page, you have to enter your basic education details like 10th, 12th, and your basic qualification. What you did in nursing, whether it is BSc, GNM, or ANM. After selection of the course, it will ask to further to enter the details like in which state you have studied your course, then type of institute, whether it is government or private, the name of the institute, the name of the university or board, and year of passing. You have to enter the all details. Here in the name of university and board tab, you have to select university for BSc nursing, and for GNM and ANM you have to select the board name. Please keep in mind that you have to select the name of university or board where you are studied. I am saying this because of don't get confused with the current registration certificate. If you having any additional qualification, you can update here. If you did post BSc or MSc nursing after the basic qualification, you can enter here. If no, then submit no. In this page, you can enter your service details if you are doing job, you can enter the job details here. After successfully entering the vault details, you have to finally upload your certificates like your 10th class certificate or date of birth proof, signature, registration certificate and additional qualification certificate. If you did additional qualification, then only you have to select it. But keep in mind that you have to upload the documents below 100 KB. Up to 100 KB only it is allowed. For that, you can use one tool is there, sniping tool. You can snipe that and you have to create an image from here like this way. After successfully uploading the documents, you have to update it. Then it will show that your form is completed. Please take a print of this page to make sure that there is no correction. Please take a printout and just go through the details that you have filled. After cross verifying the vault details, you can submit it. Then it will show that your application is successfully authenticated. So also it's showing that you have to visit the State Nursing Council for other based biometric verification, your photo capture and certificate verification. Before going to State Nursing Council, call them, ask them whether you can come or not for the biometric verification. So thank you for watching me. If you have any doubts, please ask me in the comment box.